Black Christmas songs, basically R&B Christmas songs, have a certain delectable flavor to them that's easy to recognize. There are a total of 7 in the Billboard Top 100 Holiday Hits of all time. Stay tuned and I'll tell you how they fared across the decades. Now, Billboard simply tells us the all-time top 100 recordings of Christmas music based on streaming, airtime, record sales, etc. They run this list every year for about 4 to 5 weeks at a time for the last couple of decades. They don't actually divide the list by race or genre. But at one point in time, they did. There was a category that was called race records once upon a time. This eventually became rhythm and blues. So I guess, in a way, I'm taking a step backwards. There are actually two ways to approach this list. There are songs written by black artists, essentially R&B Christmas songs. And there are traditional Christmas songs, or songs that are penned by other composers that charted best when sung by black artists. I'll explore both categories. So first, let's look at all the songs written by black artists. Coming in as the number 7th most popular black Christmas song is Run DMC Christmas and Hollis. There have been a few Christmas rap songs over the years. 1979, Curtis Blow, Christmas Rappin'. The Cold Crew, also titled Christmas Rappin', and from 1982. And even Eazy-E, Merry Motherfucking Christmas. I actually listened to this song just for research purposes. My goodness, it has so little to do with Christmas. Okay, but Run DMC broke away from the pack as the only rap song to make it into the Billboard Holiday 100, coming in at number 97. Written and recorded in 1987, it appeared on a compilation Christmas album featuring various artists, and it was titled A Very Special Christmas. The album was actually created to benefit the Special Olympics. Other artists on the project included Whitney Houston, Sting, Bruce Springsteen, Madonna, and Bob Seger. Hollis, Queens is the neighborhood where the group grew up together. This is a really fun song and a fun music video that I actually heard and saw for the first time while I was compiling this list. Now, I'm a child from the 80s and 90s, and I started to listen to hip-hop music around 1990, growing up in the DC area, but the stations that I listened to never played this song. And after all these years, somehow I managed to miss it. I never knew it existed. But if you go to the song on YouTube to watch the video, there are an army of loyal fans who absolutely love this song. Run so loud and proud, you hear it. It's Christmas time and we got the spirit. Jack Frost chilling, the hawk is out, and that's what Christmas is all about. The time is now, the place is here, and the whole wide world is filled with cheer. My name's DMC with the mic in my hand, and I'm chilling and cooling just like a snowman. The number 6 most popular black Christmas song is What Christmas Means to Me, Stevie Wonder. He first recorded this song in 1967 on the album Someday at Christmas. Interestingly enough, the prolific singer-songwriter did not actually write this classic. Alan Story, Anna Gordy Gay, and George Gordy, the children of Berry Gordy, are credited as the writers. And that Gay? Yeah, that was indeed the famed Marvin Gaye. This woman was the child of Berry Gordy and the wife of Marvin Gaye. They married in 1963 and divorced in 1975. The version sung by Stevie Wonder is rated number 95 on the Hot 100 holiday list. And John Legend's version comes in at 76 on that list. Like I never seen before. If I know I love you madly, it seems I love you more. The lips of cards you give me will touch my heart for some. Most popular Christmas song is This Christmas, written by Donnie Hathaway and recorded in 1970. His co-writer is credited as Nadine Teresa McKinnor, and to me, this is the definitive black Christmas song. It has everything. It has a great melody, has just a soulful delivery from almost everybody who's ever sung it. The version performed by Donnie Hathaway, its original writer, ranks number 49 on the Holiday 100 list. And there's another version performed by Chris Brown, which ranks number 94 on this list.
Christmas, the fireside is blazing bright. We're caroling through the night, and this Christmas will be a very special Christmas for me.
The number four Black Christmas song is It's Chuck Berry, Run Rudolph Run, coming in at number 37. This song is so old that the sound was unrecognizable to my wife as black music. She actually thought that this was a country song. It was recorded in 1958, and interestingly enough, because Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer was a trademark name, Chuck Berry got sued for writing this song by the creator of that character, a man by the name of Johnny Marks, who was given songwriting credits and hence royalties for life. Despite not doing a damn thing to create the melody, the lyrics, or anything. Interestingly enough, this song has actually charted on the Billboard country charts. So maybe my wife had something. In 2008, it was number 42 on the country charts, and in 2012, it reached number 58 on the country charts. The number three Black Christmas song is Christmas, Please Come Home by Darlene Love. Not to be mistaken for Please Come Home for Christmas, which is coming up. Darlene Love is the original singer, and this song definitely has a black sound and feel, but the credited writers are two Jewish folks, Ellie Greenwich and Jeff Berry. Phil Spector is also credited, but he was an exceptionally powerful individual at that time. And part of me wonders if he simply had the leverage to get his name listed as a writer, since he produced the album that it appeared on, which was a 1963 Christmas compilation album titled A Christmas Gift for You from Phil Spector. Darlene Love's version appears at number 31 on this list, while Michael Bublé's version comes in at number 68. The number two Black Christmas song is Please Come Home for Christmas. Different song. Makes you wonder why black folks have to be asked to come home for Christmas so much. I mean, is it so much to ask just to come home once a year? Anyway, the song was written and originally recorded by blues singer Charles Brown in 1961 when it peaked at number 76 in that year's Billboard 100 rankings. The version that actually topped this list is by the Eagles, and it came in at number 25. Their version was recorded in 1978, and it peaked at number 18 on the Billboard Hot 100 that year. And of course, the number one black song is the number one Christmas song for all time. All I Want for Christmas Is You. Now, I'll go on the record as saying that when I was a teenager, I thought Mariah Carey looked like a white girl who sung and performed music like a black woman. I didn't really see her as a black woman, and even now, she just doesn't really strike me as a black woman. But, you know, who am I to say what a black woman is? Not to go too far down that rabbit hole. But she prefers to be seen as a black woman. And her father was some degree of black. So I guess that settles it. Michael Bublé's version of this song ranks number 52 on this list. Interestingly enough, years before her song was first released in 1994, a song of the exact same name by Vince Vance and the Valiants was released. And I actually like that version quite a bit. Don't want a Christmas that's blue.
back to tinsel, stockings and bows, 'cause all I want for Christmas is you. I don't need expensive things.
Technically, it's classified as like country or something like that. It was released in 1989. And it charts number 89 on this list. Now, this artist, Vince Vance, he actually filed a lawsuit this year based on the fact that Mariah Carey's version used the same name as his song. And I believe he's a little salty that it has rendered his song almost historically invisible. When I try to look up his song, you actually have to know his name in order to even find it. Because every time you type in that title, Mariah Carey's song comes up. And his does not. Now, the melodies and the lyrics are very different, but still, they were first, and they feel like they have a right to some of Mariah Carey's dough. So we'll see how that pans out. The lawsuit was literally filed this year, 2022. So, you know anything about lawsuits, you realize it's going to take a while. Now, as I stated before, there are many black singers in the Holiday Top 100 who are performing covers of traditional or pop songs that are mainstream. Coming in number 11 on this list is Whitney Houston singing Do You Hear What I Hear? This song was originally written by married couple Noelle Regney and Gloria Shane, and it was written as a plea for peace during the Cuban Missile Crisis in 1962, which, if you remember, is when the United States and USSR were on the brink of destroying the entire planet with nuclear weapons. Whitney Houston's version ranks at number 85, while Bing Crosby's version lands at number 87 on the all-time hot holiday list.
Said the shepherd boy to the mighty.
Now, number 10 on the black cover list is Darlene Love singing Winter Wonderland. This song was originally written in 1934 by Felix Bernard and Richard Bernhard Smith. Darlene Love's version of the song comes in at number 80 on the Holiday All-Time list, and it appears on the 1963 album, Christmas Gift for You, which was produced by future murderer Phil Spector. Relative newcomers Pentatonix sing a version of the song that comes in at number 98 on the All-Time list. The number 9 on the cover list, black folks sing the classics, is Nat King Cole's performance of O Come All Ye Faithful, which arrives at number 75 on the all-time holiday list. This song is basically ancient compared to everything else on this list. The song has been attributed to various authors, including John Francis Wade, who lived from 1711 to 1786, John Redding, who lived from 1645 to 1692, and King John IV of Portugal, who lived from 1604 to 1656, I'm pretty sure we can guess a king did not write this. It has also been attributed to some anonymous Cistercian monks. The earliest printed version is in a book published by John Francis Wade, a manuscript by Wade which dated back to 1751. And is held by Stonyhurst College at Lancashire, England. Nat King Cole's arrangement reached the public in 1960 on his album titled The Magic of Christmas, which featured two angelic white babies on the front with a perfectly decorated Christmas tree. These people were taking zero chances that this album would not sell well. No need to risk it all by putting a black person on the front.
Christ the Lord.
Oh, Now, number 8 on the Black Folks Sing the Greats list is The Temptations' performance of Silent Night. Coming in at number 73 on the all-time list, Silent Night is another song from antiquity. Well, I mean, relative antiquity. Okay, well, the song existed before sound recording existed. Silent Night was originally written in German, and it was composed in 1818 by Franz Xaver Gruber, with lyrics by Joseph Moore, in the small town of Oberndorf bei Salzburg in Austria. I probably didn't say that right. The Temptations recording was released on the album The Temptations Christmas Card in 1970. Number 7 on the Black Folks Sing the Greats list is the Jackson 5's performance of I Saw Mommy Kissing Santa Claus from the Jackson 5 Christmas album released in 1970. This song is actually one of my favorites, and it's at number 65 on the all-time holiday hits list. Number 6 on the list of Black Folks Sing Holiday Classics is Nat King Cole's performance of Deck the Halls, released on his 1960 album, The Magic of Christmas. Deck the Halls is a traditional Christmas carol. The melody is Welsh, dating back to the 16th century, with English lyrics written by the Scottish musician Thomas Oliphant, which date back to 1862.
See the blazing Yule before us. Strike the harp and join the chorus. Follow me in merry measure, while I tell of Yuletide treasure. Fa la 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 la, fa la 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 la.
Number 5 on the Black Folks Getting It Done list is White Christmas by the Drifters. This comes in at number 62 on the all-time holiday list. Recorded in 1954, it is a cover of what may be the most popular Christmas song of all time, if all sales from previous decades were tallied up and counted on this list. The song was originally written by Irving Berlin for the musical film Holiday Inn in 1942. Bing Crosby is responsible for making this song famous as it was, with his version reaching number 10. On the all-time holiday greats list.
Christmas card arrived. May your days be merry and bright. And may all your Christmases be white.
Number 4 on the Black Folks cover list is the Jackson 5 singing Santa Claus is Coming to Town from their 1970 album titled The Jackson 5 Christmas Album. This song was originally written by J. Fred Coots and Haven Gillespie. The earliest known recording was from banjoist Harry Reaser and his band, playing on the radio in October of 1934. It was sung on Eddie Cantor's radio show, and immediately 500,000 copies of the sheet music were sold, as long as 30,000 records within 24 hours. Those sound like internet impossible numbers, but that's what's on Wikipedia. The Jackson 5 version is currently ranked number 42 on the all-time Christmas song list. Coming in at number 3 on my list is Eartha Kitt's performance of Santa Baby from 1953. It ranks number 30 on the all-time list. The song was written by Joan Javits and Philip Springer, sometimes known as Tony Springer. Lyrically, the song is kind of a tongue-in-cheek, jokey kind of feel, with a woman making a plea to Santa Claus for a bunch of materialistic luxury items. Now, this song isn't exactly a cover, but it's also not uniquely black, in my opinion. It has more of a pop feel to it than anything R&B. So it was written by some white folks who then turned over and gave it to Eartha Kitt, who then turned it into what it is. But over the years, it has not been covered by R&B stars. Whenever somebody else sings this song, it's always a pop star, not an R&B star. The lyrical content of Santa Baby proved controversial. It even got temporarily banned in the southern United States, probably because the men were finding themselves uncomfortably aroused by Eartha Kitt's delivery. If you remember, Eartha Kitt was, in her day, possibly the sexiest woman alive. Probably the sexiest woman alive, if you've ever seen photos of her. The actual writer of this song said that he was disappointed in the way it turned out and considered it one of his weakest works. And some people have voted it as the worst Christmas song ever. The year after they released it, they reworked it and changed the lyrics. But as you can see, 70 years later, this stands as one of the most popular Christmas songs ever created.
Santa baby, and fill my stocking with the duplex. And checks. Sign your X on the line, Santa cutie, and hurry down the chimney tonight. Come and trim my Christmas tree with some decorations bought at Tiffany. I really do believe in you. Let's see if you believe in me.
Number 2 on this list is the Ronettes cover of Sleigh Ride, released in 1963 on the album Christmas Gift for You. That was a very popular album. The original song had no lyrics and was simply an orchestra piece composed between 1946 and 1948 by Leroy Anderson. The lyrics were added a couple of years later by Mitchell Parrish. The Ronettes version ranks number 13 on the all-time Christmas list. Now, the number one cover, which isn't exactly a cover, it's sort of the original, is Nat King Cole, The Christmas Song, which is number 4 on the all-time Christmas list. His version was released in 1960 on his album, The Magic of Christmas. The original was written in 1945 by Robert Wells and Mel Torme. Originally, it was recorded in 1946, then again in 1953, and then again in 1961. The 1961 version is generally regarded as the definitive version. But the original 1946 recording was inducted into the Grammy Hall of Fame in 1974. Now, this is another example of a song originally sung by a black artist, but that I do not consider really black music, because it doesn't have a unique, soulful R&B song to it. It's more of a crooner vibe.
A turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way.
And that completes both lists. Now, there are a couple of songs I expected to see here, and I'm surprised they didn't make the top 100, even though everyone knows they're great songs. The first would be Someday at Christmas by Stevie Wonder. I first remember hearing this song while we were at war in Iraq and I was in the military back in 2003, and it just really resonated with me at that moment, as everything he said in that song hit home for me. I was not actually in combat, but I was responsible for a unit that was in combat and delivering news of wounded and things like that. It just had an impact on me. And then Give Love at Christmas by the Jackson 5. I really feel like this is one of the best songs ever written with regards to the feeling that everyone has on that Christmas morning when they want to just be nice to other people and share this sort of togetherness feeling.
Buying special gifts.
And then, of course, Holiday by Lil Nas. I don't know why that didn't really make it to the top of the list. It should have been somewhere in the middle of the pack. I don't understand. Maybe next time, or maybe a decade from now, it'll have a resurgence and people will understand the brilliance of Lil Nas's It's a Holiday. All right, well, hey, that concludes my list. Everyone, have a wonderful Christmas. Thank you for joining me. Till next time.